It's time to set up your Facebook pixel. In this episode, I will show you how to install the Facebook pixel in Clickfunnels in less than 10 minutes. Best of all, everything we do will be iOS 14 update compliant. That means the tracking in our Facebook pixel will be optimized for the god-awful iOS update. I will show you four simple things you need to do and will walk you step by step through the entire setup process as quick as possible so that you can start running your Facebook ads ASAP. There's not a moment to lose. Let's get started. There are four things we need to do in order to have your pixel up and running, ready to record everything that happens on your website. First, we need to install a Chrome extension called the Pixel Helper, which will allow us to see immediately if our pixel was installed correctly on each of our web pages. Second is the actual pixel setup process, and we'll create your pixel and give it an identity. Third, we will create two custom events. This will record when a person lands on your landing page and when they opted into your business. Normally, three steps is all we need, and we will be able to call it a day and end it there. However, with the iOS 14 update, Facebook now highly recommends that we set a priority for our events, which will help with more accurate reporting and data collection. So we have to add step four, which is to prioritize the events that we have created in step three. So that's what we are going to do today. Ready? All right, let's get started. Open up Google and type in Pixel Helper. You will see the link that's called Facebook Pixel Helper. Click on it. You will then arrive at this page. Download this Chrome extension and pin it to your taskbar. It will look like this at the top right-hand corner of your Chrome window. We are done with step one. Let's go to step two, which is to create the pixel and give it an identity. Open up your Ads Manager. Click the All Tools icon and select Events Manager. At the left-hand side, click on the green plus button. Facebook will ask you what kind of data source you want to connect. We want to create a pixel that will track web traffic, so select Web and click Connect. Select Facebook Pixel and click Connect. Now you can name your pixel. You can name it after your business or the niche of your product. I will just call mine IG Profits. We can ignore the URL field and press Continue. Click on the button that says Install Code Manually. Facebook will then provide us with the base code. This is the tracking code that will go on each and every page of your website. You can see Facebook tells you to paste the code into the bottom of the header section just above the head tag. You can do that right now for your own web pages. For my example, I will show you how to install it onto your ClickFunnels landing page. Click on the green copy code, then open up the funnel that you want to install this code. Go to the Settings tab and click on it. We will be pasting our Facebook pixel into the field that says Head Tracking Code. You can see the code is now pasted. Scroll to the bottom of the page and click Save and Update Settings. Now, let's go back to the Events Manager and click Continue. Here, you are given the option to turn on Automatic Events Matching. This will allow Facebook to match people who lands on your website with their records. Turn this on. You will see all the information that Facebook will try to record and match with info that they have on the visitor, which is great. Click Continue. Facebook will then ask you if you want to open the Events Setup tool to install events directly onto your website. This is a little complicated to do. Close this window, and we will set up your events another way that's easier. But before we do that, you see how it says that your pixel hasn't received any activities yet? Well, we need to open up your website once to give the pixel some activity. Simply go back to your funnel and open up your landing page. Now go back to the Events Manager and refresh the page. You should see this page. This page signifies that your pixel is set up correctly. If you don't see this page, reload your landing page again and come back and refresh this page. Sometimes this process is instant. Other times it may take half an hour or so please be patient. Once you see this page, we are done with step two, done with the pixel setup. For step three, we need to create two custom events. to record when a person lands on your landing page, viewed your content, and when they opted into your business, which is a lead. Let's do that right now. With your pixel selected, click on the green Create button at the top right-hand corner. Then select Create Custom Conversion. Let's create our first event, our first custom conversion. We will call this conversion Viewed Landing Page. You'll see that for the data source, our pixel name is selected. Then click on the link, select your own category. Click on the dropdown and select Viewed Content, because that is what a viewed landing page event is. Then open your landing page, grab the URL on top, copy it, and then come back and paste it in this field. Then click Create and hit Done. All right, our first conversion event is created. On to the second one. Click on the Create button again and select Create Custom Conversion. This will be called Lead because someone has given you their email address and landed on your thank you page. Click Select Your Own Category. Scroll and find the Lead category and select it. Then go back to your funnel and open up your thank you page. Grab the URL at the top and paste it back in the field. Hit Create and done. Now, let's see if our pixel was installed correctly on our pages, shall we? Give it a minute or two and then open up your landing page. Remember we installed the Pixel Helper Chrome extension earlier? Refresh the page and click on the little pixel icon. And you'll see that it recognizes our IG Profits pixel is installed. There's a page view and there's a viewed landing page data that we just created. Great. Now let's open our thank you page and check to see if our pixel was installed correctly on this page as well. Refresh this page and click on the little pixel icon. And you'll notice that there's a page view and a lead data too. Awesome. If we go back to our events manager under the custom conversions, you'll see two conversions that we just created. The status reads inactive. Well, let's refresh this page. And voila, both are active now. Congrats, step 3 is done. Normally, at this point, we'll call it a day, go grab some drinks, and go to party. But because of the iOS update, gosh darn it, Facebook highly recommends that you now set a priority of our events. This will help with more accurate reporting and data collection. So let's get that done right now. Click on Data Sources. Scroll to the bottom and click on Aggregated Event Measurement. And click on Configure Web Events. In order to prioritize events, you do have to first verify your domain name with Facebook. To do that, click on Manage Domains. Click on the blue Add button. Then put in your domain name. Facebook will then give you a meta tag and ask you to copy it and put it in the head section of your website's homepage. For example, in ClickFunnels, you will open up your landing page in edit mode, click Settings, and select Tracking Code, and then paste the meta tag into the header code section and hit Save. Then go back to the business settings on Facebook and click Verify Domain, and your domain will be verified. Now we can finally prioritize our events. So go back to the data sources section of our events manager. Scroll down to the aggregated event measurement tab and click configure web events. Your domain should be displayed here. Click on it and select manage events and click edit. Now comes the easy and fun part. Click the green add event button. Select the name of your pixel. For me, it's called IG Profits. For the event name, remember our first conversion? Our first event name was called Viewed Content? Well, let's select it. Now let's add the second event. So click Add Event. Select the pixel that this event belongs to. And under event name, find our second event, which is called Lead. And select it. This is what Facebook wants you to do. Prioritize the event. Since a lead is more important than a view content, we simply grab the lead row and drag it to the top. Now that is the highest priority, and we will be done. in the future when you add more events such as purchases. I'll show you an example. We will do the same thing. Add event, select the pixel it belongs to, and select the purchased event. And since purchased is more important than a lead, you will in the future drag the purchase event to the top. But since we're just running a lead campaign right now, we only have two events to worry about. We are now officially done with setting up your Facebook pixel. Congratulations! When I first learned how to set everything up years ago, this process took me several days to learn. But we just did it in less than 10 minutes. Very cool indeed. So, what do you think? Do you have any questions or problems when setting up your Facebook pixel? Let me know in the comments and I will create new tutorials to make sure you get your pixel installed correctly. Now that you have your pixels installed, let me show you how to set up your ad campaigns. Don't forget to hit the subscribe button and the notification button, because in the next episode, I will show you how to set up a high-converting Facebook ad campaign from start to finish, step by step. I will also share a targeting option secret with you, a secret developed by my clients and I that allows us to target our ideal customers while lowering the cost of our ad spend and lead cost. We call it the 3-flavor ice cream targeting strategy, and I can't wait to explain it to you in a fun way. I'll see you in the next episode.